Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. If you are able to stand to your feet and give the Lord a hand clap of praise, come on and go with me this morning as we glorify him on this Youth Sunday. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God is so good. He is so great. He is greatly to be praised. We thank you for coming out on today. We thank you, Lord God, for our youth. We thank you for this ministry. You stand to your feet this morning. Stand up on your feet. Stand up on your feet. Stand up on your feet and put those hands together for the Lord this morning. Come on, put your hands together. Hallelujah. This is the dressing up room down here. This is where our children get their start, right here. This is their foundation. And if they don't see us doing it, they're not going to do it. So come on and let's cry out and exalt the Lord this morning. Lord, you're good, oh Lord. Lord, you're good. Come on, sing with me. Lord, you're good. Lord, you're good. Oh, Lord, you're good. Lord, you are good. Yeah, Lord, you are good.
You, if you allow the Lord in your life, if you give your life totally to him, all of those pains, hallelujah, hallelujah, all of those pains will go away, hallelujah, all of those pains will vanish, hallelujah. It just takes one step. That's accepting him as your Lord and Savior. Accepting him as your Lord and Savior. Now, even if your feet are hurting, if your shoes too tight, unloosen them. If your belt too tight, unloosen it. Because I need you to go before the Lord this morning for these youth. And I need you to give him everything that is within you to help us celebrate the youth on today, to help us praise the Lord for our youth on today. We don't want to lose our youth to the world. We want to keep our youth right here. Hallelujah. This is the foundation. We want to keep them here. We want to continue to encourage them. We want to continue to keep them in our arms. We want to continue to love on them. Amen. 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 I'm afraid to tell y'all to sit down because you might not get back up. So I'm going to say y'all take a seat. Now don't let me have to come back because I will get you up. Hallelujah. Because God's been so good to me. Now I don't know about you. I can only talk about me. But God has been good to me. Hallelujah. 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 Now I'm going to go ahead on and turn this over into the hands of our MC this morning, my baby. I'm going to go ahead. Y'all give my baby a hand. Come on and give it to her.
Good morning. My name is Demetria Renfro, and I will serve as your MC for today's Youth Sunday service. We have a great program to present to you today. Our youth ministry has worked really hard over the past few weeks to prepare for this day, and we are excited to have you join us. For our program today, we will have a scripture reading and prayer, poems, and songs presented by our youth. We will also have a skit performed exclusively by our youth drama ministry. We will deliver our weekly announcements and end with closing remarks. Thank you for being here this morning. We ask that you please support and encourage our young people as they present their part of the program. They have all worked so hard to put on a special program for you this morning, and we hope you enjoy it. Amen. Without further delay, we will begin with our first performance. At this time, we have a solo performed by Haley Hall, accompanied by Tyler Searles on the drums. Please put your hands together and extend a warm welcome to Haley and Tyler.
Good morning. My name is Haley Hall, and I will be singing a solo called He's Got the Whole World in His Hands. 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 He's got the little tiny baby in his hands. He's got the little tiny baby in his hands. He's got the little tiny baby.
Tyler, for that beautiful performance. Now, we will have a scripture reading by Jamari Hansley.
Good morning. My name is Jamari Hansley. I'll read a scripture from Matthew 4:14-16. You are the light of the world. A city set on the hill cannot be hidden. Nor do people light a lamp and put it under a basket, but on a stand, and it gives light to all in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before others, so that they may see your good works and give glory to God, to you, to your Father who is in heaven. Thank you.
Thank you, Jamari. And now Rashara Birch will lead us in prayer.
Good morning. My name is Rashara Birch, and I will be doing this prayer. Please stand and bow your heads. Dear God, thank you for this day. Thank you for allowing us to be here today and celebrate you. God, thank you for my mom and my dad. Thank you for my friends. Help everyone here today. I just thank you, God, for everything. I love you, God, and this is my prayer in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Ray Short. Our first poem reading will be presented by Gabrielle Staples. Please welcome Gabrielle.
Good morning. My name is Gabrielle Staples, and I will be reading a poem called Summer, Summer by Sarah Griffin. Summer, summer, I'm so glad you're here. Summer, summer, let's give a cheer. Summer, summer, I'll meet you at the park. Summer, summer, let's stay up till dark. Thank you.
Thank you, Gabrielle. Our next poem reading will be presented by Jacob Underwood. Please welcome Jacob.
Good morning. My name is Jacob Underwood, and I'll be reading a poem about education. For some, it's a privilege. For others, it's a right. The difference between darkness and a future that is bright. Some will take a burden where others see a gift, the key to moving forward and give your life a lift. If school is not your calling, look beyond the doors. The world can be a teacher, many adventures are in store. As long as you're learning, your education grows, that will lead to your contributions as you share things you know. Thanks.
Thank you, Jacob. Now we will have a solo performance by Tanasia Hill. Please welcome Tanasia.
Good morning. My name is Tanasia Hill, and I will be singing a song for you all.
Sunday,
I need you always, not just for one day. Oh Lord, I don't wanna have to wait till Sunday. I need you always, not just for one day. I don't wanna have to wait till Wednesdays. Don't bother me much. Thursday's easy cause I got your love. Go back to before I knew what it was. No, I don't stress about no Fridays. Cause Fridays, when that check gon' come, 10%, then I could have a little fun. Weekend, I could chill or some. Me and you a little one-on-one. So my mind's made up, I'ma stay prayed up. It's been a long week, I don't wanna have to wait till Sunday. I need you always, not just for one day. Oh Lord, I don't wanna have to wait till Sunday. I need you always, not just for one day. I don't wanna have to wait till Monday. I really need you Tuesday. I really need you. Oh, I don't wanna have to wait. I don't wanna have to wait. I don't wanna have to wait. Oh, no, no. I don't wanna have to wait till Sunday. I need you always, not just for one day. Oh, Lord, I don't wanna have to wait till Sunday. I need you always, not just for one day. I don't wanna have to wait till Sunday.
Y'all, come on, give Tanasia another hand. Listen. I just have to say this because Tanasia really wanted to sing today. And I said, Tanasia, I said, what song do you want to sing? She said, I don't know. So I sent her a lot of different songs that she could, that I thought she could minister to. And this particular song touched her because it's talking about not waiting till Sunday to accept Christ. It's talking about not waiting until you get here to give him everything within you. I don't know if you understood the meaning of the song, but not waiting till Sunday, having him in your life Monday through Saturday before you get here on Sunday, that's what's important, and that's what she was singing about. Not just waiting till Sunday. Adults, we are adults. Sometimes we don't get it until we get here on Sunday. So let's use that song as an encouragement. Instead of waiting till you get here on Sunday morning to give him your all, do it when you wake up on Monday morning and carry it throughout the week. Hallelujah. Put your hands together again for Tanasia. Thank you.
Thank you, Tanasia, for that awesome performance. Please prepare for our church announcements presented by Morgan Hall and assisted by Haley Hall.
Good morning. Please direct your attention to the monitors for the announcements for Sunday, June 30th, 2024. An announcement for the praise team. Rehearsal will be held on Friday, July 12th at 6 p.m. We had our youth and family outing yesterday. Even though rain was forecasted for the day, the Lord had greater plans for us to enjoy a day of fellowship. Amen?
Amen.
We had a wonderful time. Thank you to all who assisted with the planning, setup, food, and concessions. Thank you to everyone who came out as well. If you missed out yesterday, we look forward to seeing you at our next event. Reminder, the men's online prayer group meets weekly. Please note the phone and access code information available on the screen. For anyone requesting prayer, a reminder that you may place your prayer requests in the basket up front, as we'll be praying for them weekly.
Amen.
We also ask that you keep Brother Lewis Sullen in your prayers as he continues to recover. And now we have a special youth spotlight to shine on Tyler Searles. Tyler launched a new business venture this summer. He started Tyler's Extra Help Service to assist with light household chores. Please keep him in mind if you need assistance this summer. If you need help, please see Tyler or his parents. Congratulations, Tyler, and keep up the good work.
Amen. Scripture of the week. I will be reading from the King James Version. Scripture comes from Daniel chapter 6, verse 3, and it reads, "Then this Daniel was preferred above the presidents and princes, because an excellent spirit was in him. And the king thought to set him over the whole realm." Amen?
Amen.
And now, we would like to acknowledge our first-time visitors. If we have any, please stand. No? Oh, okay. On behalf of Pastor Slater, First Lady, and the members of Family Life, we welcome and thank you for visiting with us today. We invite you to please join us for Life Enrichment Studies online Wednesday at 6:30 p.m. And we welcome you back to join us for Sunday morning service at 11:15 a.m. Finally, we wish everyone a safe and blessed 4th of July holiday. This concludes the announcements for this Sunday. Thank you.
Thank you for the announcements, Morgan and Haley. And now we'll have another poem reading presented by Haley Hall.
Success. Success is not a number, a thing, or someplace real. Success is about attitude and dreams and what you feel. Success can mean nothing if your happiness is lost. What is making millions when it yields a heavy cost? History might judge us, but what matters most is now. Enjoying well the things we have is the most sacred vow. You need not to go in search of success. It's closer than you know. Just enjoy those things around you and watch your success grow. Thank you.
Thank you, Haley, for that amazing poem. We'll have another poem reading by Caleb Underwood.
Good morning. My name is Caleb Underwood, and I'll be reading a poem called "You Can." If you think you are beaten, you are. If you dare, you dare not, you don't. If you like to win but think you can't, it's almost a chance you won't. If you think you'll lose, you're lost. For out in the world, you find success begins with a fellow's will. It's all in the state of mind. If you think you're outclassed, you are. You got to think high to rise. You got to be sure of yourself. You got to be sure of yourself before you can ever win a prize. Life battles don't always go to the stranger or faster man, but sooner or later, the one who wins is the one who thinks he can. Thank you.
Thank you, Caleb. For the next part of our program, we will be graced with a dance performed by Jamari Hensley. Please join me in welcoming Jamari.
Mm-hmm.
but you did it. You made a way. Standing here, not knowing how we'll get through this test, but holding on to faith you know best. Nothing can catch you by surprise. You got this figured out, and you're watching us now. And when it looks as if we can't win, you wrap us in your arms and step in. And everything we need you supply. You got this in control, and now we know that you made a way.
When our backs were against the wall, and it looked as if it was over,
Lord, you made a way. And we're standing here,
and we're standing here
only because
you made a way.
You made a way. I'm burning on the inside. I don't know how y'all can sit in your seat. I'm burning on the inside because he made a way. Oh, come on, put your hands together for the Lord.
Thank you, Jamari, for that wonderful performance. Are you guys enjoying the program so far? Let's give our youth another hand. Now we will transition to the next part of our program. At this time, our youth drama ministry will present a skit entitled, I'm Gonna Let It Shine. As a young adult, Let Your Light Shine is a powerful concept rooted in Christian teachings. In Matthew chapter 5, verse 16, Jesus encourages believers to let your light shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father in heaven. This refers to the positive change within you and that your inner glow, in the inner glow that comes from your relationship with God. It's the assurance that God is your Father, Jesus is your Savior, and the Holy Spirit guides your path. This is exemplified in your words, actions, and thoughts. The visible impact of your light shining is when others notice the difference in your character, your kindness, and your service. It is all about living your life genuinely and showing God's love to those around you. Remember, you are called to be a light, so embrace your faith, live it out, and let your light shine brightly. When Becky and Jackson discover a bright light, they try to brighten the darkness around them. While Abby dislikes having the light as it reveals what's going on around her, she's frustrated, angry, and aggressive. Debbie convinces everyone to keep the light shining to help guide people out of the darkness and to help Abby discover the joy in letting her light shine.
Sure can't write to school.
No. I don't know.
Y'all ready for these tests today?
Not me, yes.
I know I'm a cheat. And I'm ready for lunch. It's too long. Whoa, that is bright. This is so awesome. We finally have a light source.
Yeah, we're going to be able to see for miles. Well, actually, everyone around us is going to be able to see for miles. We can all start tripping in the dark now.
We're like a lighthouse. Awesome.
Hey, can you tone that down a bit? You're going to blind me.
Oh, we're sorry, I guess.
Don't you want to be able to see?
Frankly, no. I like things the way they were before, hidden. Your light is seeping into every little dark crevice, and I don't appreciate it. There are just some things I don't want to see.
Well, hold on. Let me look around and see if I can find a dimmer light switch for you or something.
Well, hurry up. You're offending me. You don't have the right to shine that light anywhere you want. It's disturbing.
Okay. Calm down. I turned it off. Look, we're sorry. We thought people would want to see.
Can I ask you, why would you want to stumble around in the dark?
None of your business. Just keep your light to yourself.
Good grief. I didn't expect that. I'm almost afraid to turn it back on.
Me too. I don't want to upset no one.
I have an idea. Let's turn it on and cover it real quick with the trash can I saw over there a few minutes ago.
Good idea. On three. One, two, three.
Jesus expects us to let our light shine. In other words, the dark, lost world should see the light of Jesus shining through you so that it draws them to him. For example, we don't pay the light bill, the electric bill, and then sit in the dark. We utilize the light through electricity so that we are able to see where we are going. And our lives reflect the light of Christ. And if we are, and if we say we are his children, why not show people who our Father is by representing him and allowing our light to shine bright? Ephesians chapter 5, verse 8 through 9, for you were once darkness, but now you are light in the Lord. Walk as children of light, for the fruit of the Spirit is in all goodness, righteousness, and truth. Let's continue to witness and watch as the cast returns.
I know I saw the light coming from somewhere this way. Ouch, oh, that hurts.
Hey, is someone out there?
Yeah, who's there? Where are you? Did you see that light earlier?
We're over here. Follow my... Oh, whoa, are you okay? I'm Jackson, and I'm here with my friend Becky.
Hi, I'm good, thanks. I'm Debbie. Why are you guys out here? Did you see the light earlier? I'm trying to find it, but it seems to have gone out.
Actually, we're trying to figure out what to do with it.
With what, the light?
Yes, Debbie.
You have the light? Is it on?
Yes.
Yes, it's on.
Yes, it sure is.
Is it plugged in?
Yes, it's plugged in.
Well, where is it?
Under that trash can.
Okay, but why is the light under the trash can?
We kind of don't want anyone to see it.
Okay, so what you're saying is that you have the light, and it's turned on, but it's hidden under the trash can because you don't want nobody to see it?
Exactly.
Yeah.
Hey, that's about the size of a Debbie.
But we're all stumbling around in the dark.
Yes, we know.
This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. We have all hummed this catchy tune a time or two, or even sang it in church during devotion or praise and worship. When Jesus said, "Let your light shine, that they may see your good deeds and glorify your Father in heaven," he wasn't talking about making sure you turned on your porch lights at night. He was referencing letting the Holy Spirit shine bright within us. To be the light in times of darkness means you should offer hope when there is none. You offer encouragement when it is needed most. You offer kindness despite being surrounded by hate. You offer patience when you're met with impatience. You offer to pick up another, dust them off, give them a hand so that their light can shine and glow. You offer Jesus. Your words, thoughts, prayers, and actions are connected to Jesus, and it shows through the lights of your soul. As the cast returns, let us witness the change once Abby understands the purpose and the brightness of the light.
About y'all, but I feel like I've been stumbling around in the dark forever.
Well, hold on. Does that help a bit?
Sort of, but wouldn't it just be better to take the trash can off?
I guess so, but we heard it's too bright for some people.
Since you all feel the light is needed, I'm the one that has a problem with the light.
Abby, why do you have a problem with the light? I can barely see you in this darkness, and I wouldn't even know you were here if it weren't for your voice.
Because the light is too bright, and it's frustrating me.
Debbie, now you see why we were trying to keep the light dim? We have no problem with the light. It's so amazing. But Abby does.
That is so true. Its brightness makes this pathway so clear.
You are so right, bruh.
unless
you like walking through the darkness like some people.
Abby, why are you so frustrated by the light?
Abby, God's light is the best light in the world. You see, we weren't made to shine in the light. God created each of us to let our little light shine in the dark. There is so much darkness surrounding us in the world today, and the light is just what we need to make it.
Abby, do you understand what Becky is saying? God's light is shining.
You all don't understand what I've been through this year. I was bullied by a group of girls. I was talked about the clothes I wore, and because my hair was so messed up. I became depressed, stressed, frustrated, and angry, and that caused my grades to drop. And on top of that, my best friend had to move away, so I have nothing in my life but darkness right now.
Listen, Abby, Becky, Jackson, Carson, and Marcus, I'm not trying to tell y'all what to do, but if you have something that can save people from the dark, you shouldn't hide it. This is the end of our school year, and we should be celebrating and rejoicing in the Lord, because we either graduated from high school or was promoted to the next grade level. And some of us even survived being bullied. Y'all, it's obvious that Abby is in a dark place in her life right now, and she needs to see Jesus through us. In fact, I'm going to follow your cord if you don't mind, so I can look for another power source to turn on another light. We can drive away all of this darkness if we keep sharing the light.
I have tried to shake this dark place in my life. You all are true friends. Even though you knew I would never find solace in this darkness, you were still willing to dim the light for me. I now can see where my life can be if I allow the light to shine. So I'm going to open my heart and allow Jesus total access to wash out the darkness.
Abby, you see, the light is a source of power needed in our life to drive away darkness. We love you, and we want to embrace the light that shines through us and allow it to ignite your heart while trusting in God.
Abby, we have a power supply that spreads light to help people see what can trip them up. And during these summer months, I want you to stay encouraged and know that God loves you, and so do I.
And now you see, my fellow classmates, this is what we've been hoping for, finding the light. But we were trying to hide it all this time.
Doesn't make much sense, does it?
No.
It sure doesn't.
You know what, guys? If people want to stay in the dark around us, they might just have to put on some shades.
Ooh-wee. Now that's better.
Let's give another hand to our youth cast for their outstanding performance. All right. For our final performance, we will now have a song performed by the Staple Singers, accompanied by Tyler Searles on the drums.
My name is Savannah Staples.
My name is Gabrielle Staples.
My name is Lydia Staples.
And we will be singing This Little Light of Mine.
Yeah.
Jesus gave it to me. I'm gonna let it shine.
shine. Jesus gave it to me. I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine. Let it shine. Let it shine. All in my school. I'm gonna let it shine.
Gabrielle and Lillian and Tyler. At this time, I would like to introduce the person responsible for today's performance, Sister Michelle Fields. Please come up.
Noon, everyone. Good afternoon. Did you all have a good time this morning? Did you enjoy the skit and all of the children that came up and did their various performances? Oh, y'all, come up. Listen, I'm not trying to be negative, but back in the day, my grandma always said anything that's dead need to be buried. And I think that Family Life is truly alive, fully alive church of the living God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And all those that come here, we don't mind praising the Lord. We don't mind including you. And we don't mind getting you up out your seat. This has been an awesome, awesome time working with the children. I really, really enjoy it. Thank you, parents, for allowing me the opportunity to handle your children throughout the weeks while we practice, talking to them, encouraging them, and praying over them. Thank you so, so much. I gotta say about the Staple Singers, when I initially asked them to sing a couple years ago, I said, you know what, the Staple Singers, that's a catchy tune, the Staple Singers. And Lily, she said, T.T., is it time for me to sing yet? I said, no, baby, it's not time for me to sing. So while she was up there singing, I kept thinking, there is a movie or something I've seen. Well, the little girl was singing, this little line of mine, I'm going to let it shine. And at the church that they were at, the directress was like, you know, she's doing too much with the song and was trying to make her leave out the church. Every time she went through the door, she came right back in, just tearing it up, and she was Lillian's size. But she was trying to sing in a choir with older people. And I thought about it. I went back there and told Dwayne. I said, Dwayne, don't she remind you of that movie? Then I asked Shanita. I said, Shanita, they was like, yeah, she remind you, but y'all ever seen What's Love Got to Do with It? And Anna Mae Bullock was trying to sing as a little girl, trying to sing those gospel songs in that church. And that lady kicked her out. And she started singing the blues, R&B, or whatever. So this is what we want to do. We want to encourage our young children to continue to let their light shine. Because if they don't let it shine up in here, they're going to let it shine out in the streets. And that's not what we want. Hallelujah. Thank everybody that came out on today. I am just really overjoyed. I feel so good. Thank you, Pastor. Thank you, Diane, for allowing me an opportunity to work with the children. So now, without further ado, I want to introduce the cast for today. Okay? Cast members, when I call your name, I want you all to come up. Okay? So, playing Becky was Shamaya Birch. Come on, let's give Shamaya a hand. Playing Jackson, Jaden Williams. Let's give Jaden a hand. Debbie was played by Morgan Hall. Let's give her a hand. Carson was played by Caleb Underwood. Let's give him a hand. Caleb, you surprised me on that end. Hey, he added, I said, Caleb, you're going to have to give me some aggressiveness, and he did it. Y'all put y'all hands together again for Caleb. Yes. And playing Marcus was Jacob Underwood. Come on, Jacob. Y'all give it to him. Now, sometimes, you know, sometimes in our youth life, they are faced with challenges. They're faced with frustrations. They're faced with depression. They're faced with stress. And this can come from different things that happen in their lives, whether it's at school or home. And this is the reason why we decided to pick I'm Gonna Let It Shine today, because we want to encourage those youth. The youth that was faced with frustration and anger because she was walking in darkness and she could not see the light. Let's give it up for Abby, played by Savannah Staples. Come on and give it to her. Yes. Thank you, guys. Y'all want to take a bow? Amen. And they have already told y'all, if y'all don't want to see their light shine, y'all better get you some shades, because they're going to let it shine. All right, Cass, you can come on off. Thank you so much. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. All I have to say is get ready for the next Fifth Sunday, because it's going to be even better. Thank you again. Let me apologize. I don't like to leave anybody out, and thank you, Sister D. Sister D is just a blessing, I tell you. She is so wonderful and just so wonderful. Every time I talk to her, I'm enlightened, because she's such a sweet person. Just her words, you know, just kind of ignite you, you know. And so I want to thank her for helping me and assisting me with this project. Then I want to thank those that actually participated. I want to thank Haley. Come on, Haley. Come on up here, Haley. Like, I got to introduce my babies. Come on, Haley. Haley blessed us with the opening song and with a poem. Hallelujah. Come on, Gabby. Gabby, come on, my baby. Gabby told you about it being summer. She was happy that the summer was here because she didn't have to go to school. Oh, come on and give it up for Gabby Staples. And Lillian Staples, come on, Lily. I'm going to let my light shine, this little light of mine. Hallelujah. And my grandbaby, Rayshard Birch, come on and give it to him. Rayshard is very shy. So, you know, I have to encourage Rayshard at all times. He's very shy, like his mom. So come on and give it to him. Tanasia. Come on up here, Tanasia. Thank you so much for blessing us with that song, Sunday. Hallelujah. Jamari, y'all put y'all hands together. Oh, yes. He made a way. He made a way. Amen. Y'all come on and give it to him. Y'all take a bow. Amen, amen, amen. And let's not forget about my nephew on the drums, Tyler Searles. Come on, Ty. Yeah, yeah. Let's not forget about Tyler. Tyler, I may need you next week to help me clean a room at the house. Yeah. Y'all utilize Tyler during the summertime, because this is what it is. Because, see, like, when your children are out for the summer, you don't have nothing for them to do. They're not in summer school or in summer program. This is they teaching. This is something that they have to do. This is something that we should have them to do, to show them responsibility, show them about life skills. Isn't that right? Amen. All right, y'all can come on down off the stage. Again, thank you so much. Put your hands together for the Lord and for the parents. Thank you again.
Thank you, Sister Michelle, for those words. Before I close out, thank you for allowing me to serve as your MC for the program today. Thank you. As we come to the close of our Youth Sunday service, we pray that your hearts are full. Thank you for showing us the value and the joy in being part of the body of Christ. We pray that you continue to keep all of our young people in prayer as we face the challenges and obstacles presented to us each day, but also as we embrace the blessings God has so richly favored us to receive. And we will have our final closing remarks from Pastor Slater. May God bless you and keep you. Thank you.
So I hope we have a list in the back. Do we have a list in the back? We have not a list, but a piece of paper in the back. So I need y'all to get y'all did a great job today. Great job. Let's give God a praise for it. So I need us to get a list in piece of paper in the back. Every young person that's in here today, I need their names. We need their names and numbers. Sister Michelle, Sister D, those of us who are working with our youth, God bless you. Thank you so much. But we're going to take even our newcomers. We want names, okay? So I should have how many names? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. They're looking at me like, what? 17, 18, 19, 20, at least 20, 21, 22, 23. We almost got the bus full. We probably have to take a vehicle or something. I'm serious about these names because I want us to get ready for, when's the next Fifth Sunday coming? Is it September? Somebody give me a calendar right quick. September? September? Morgan says September, I believe her. So it's going to be in September, all right? September, 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 September. Do you understand? Adults, I need to talk to y'all just for 3 minutes, 2 minutes, 1 minute. We need to understand that it's important that we get behind and encourage and give resources to this type ministry, because our kids are going through stuff every day. They're out for the summer. We want to pray that they have a safe summer, but we also need to pray and help them to be who they are. This is what we're going to do. This is what we need to do. What we did today is most important, and that's why we put emphasis on this. I need every adult, whether your child is here or not, or grandchild is here, I need you to get engaged. I need you to support. It ain't about who's in charge. It's about who's connected. Brothers, I appreciate you all for the logistics that you performed all the week, in particular on Saturday. Love you all. We got to keep doing that. We got to keep doing it because it's about our youth, man. God going to bless us as we pour into our youth. We got to keep this going. Now, I got one other thing I need to do because I just need to do it. When children, I'm talking to adults now, when children are participating in ministry, it's not a time to sit and watch and critique them. It's a time to encourage them. Somebody didn't hear me. When kids come up, because it's about a lot of things they have to work through just to be up here. It's a lot of things they have to work through just to come and be in rehearsal. So they work through rehearsal. They memorize all these parts, remember all these things. And then they have to come up here. And then they have to stand in front of you. And some of y'all are looking like, I'm sure I'm all looking like, and some of y'all looking like. So they got to work through all of that. They got to remember their parts, and they got to try to feel comfortable, and they can't wait till it's over with. But they're doing it because they want to be obedient. They're working through all of these things. And see, this takes me back to childhood because I went through all of this. I was always up doing something. And so we got to make sure that we encourage them, okay? How do you encourage kids? Because they need encouraging. How do you encourage kids? Not by looking at them. I'm finna shock somebody. Excellent job. Excellent job. She's ready for the any stage that calls for her. She's ready. The way you encourage children is that, yeah, good job, praise God, that's awesome, yeah, come on, do it again, yeah, thank God. That's how you encourage kids. I know y'all thought I was crazy. I knew I was going to get you. That's how you encourage kids. That's what we got to do. Now, some of the old ones, they'd be like, well, I don't need all that. But Haley and the rest of them, they deserve all that. You can't sit and look at kids when they finish doing ministry. Are y'all with me? Are you with me? Do you understand that? That's our job. Because it makes for a memorable moment that plants seeds inside of them that helps them for the rest of their life. They're going to remember these times of Fifth Sundays where they were encouraged. And so now that gives them the courage to do whatever they need to do in the academics. It gives them the courage to do what they need to do in the marketplace. And when they become senators and governors and doctors and CEOs and leaders, they will already be rooted and grounded in a foundation that they got from here. And they learn to be. See, when we encourage them, we don't have to worry about the world, because they know the saints got their back. So if the world don't say anything or the world is jealous, they don't have to worry about that, because they know that they're encouraged by the people of God, the church. So for the last time, and I'm going to digress here and we're going to pray, let's give these young folk a good God bless you, encouraging, keep on doing it. We love you. We stand behind you. You're awesome. You're great. You're fantabulous. You're anointed. You're just, oh my God. Yes! Woo! Yes! Let's go! That's what we got to have every time. So next Fifth Sunday, we don't have to rehearse this. We ain't got to worry. We already we know what to do. All right, y'all take a bow. Turn around and take a bow. All right, we're going to pray. First Lady, I want you to pray, girl. I want you to pray. I'm serious about the list. Let's get these lists. Some were here yesterday that was not here today. Let's get their names too. Let's make sure we submit their names. God is on the move. He's doing something. Our idea of how to do ministry is find out what God is working and join him. God is working with our young people. He's working in our lives. Let's make sure that we hear all that he has for us to do. Make sure that we hear every word that he's telling us to do concerning our young people. We've got all kind of activities we're talking about doing this summer before school starts and all that kind of stuff. We had a good conversation yesterday. So, young people, I need y'all to be ready. Parents, let's be ready to support. We're blessed here that we don't have to fork out a lot of funds for things that we're going to do. We do need to continue to pay your tithes and offerings so that we're able to be a blessing to these children. I am so proud of you. I'm proud of the leadership. I'm proud of everybody and all that you do. At this time, thank you for your support. First Lady Diane's coming for a prayer.
Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon. Before I pray, we all pray. I would like for the church family to remember Deacon James and Sister Rose James. They lost their son yesterday in a motorcycle accident in New York. So they will be traveling to New York later on this week. So please keep them lifted in prayer. You know, if you could call them, encourage them, let them know that we're standing with them, that we're praying for them. But that was one of the things that happened very early yesterday morning, because when I turned on my phone, that was the first text message I received. So please, let's keep them lifted in prayer, because they need our prayers. And as we continue to pray for Brother Sullins, as he continued to recover, and anyone else that's going through sickness. Sister Michelle just came up and visited. Young people, y'all get ready. Get your friends, y'all get ready. They're planning trips. That's what Pastor's, he's counting the numbers. So we got the bus ready. So activities, you know, your friends and visitors, y'all get ready. God is getting ready to move. He is moving already. Awesome job, awesome job. Continue to allow the Lord to minister through you to us, okay? Position yourselves. Position yourself. You got to do your work. You got to do your homework. Put God first. Always put God first. Everything you do it as heartily as unto the Lord, okay? Which everyone, if you would please bow your heads. And after I finish praying, if there is someone that needs prayer, if you got sickness in your body, if you don't know the Lord, first of all, if you have not received him as your Lord and Savior, that's the first thing that you need to do. Even our children, they need to know the Lord. They need a personal relationship, because we're living in perilous times. People are turning away from the faith. The enemy's tricking so many people. And that's why, you know, Sister Michelle, Sister Dee, Sister Sandy, they're working with our youth, trying to educate them on the Lord, because God needs to be first in all of our lives, not just our children, but our lives. But we want to make sure that our kids know God and that they have a relationship with him, because there is so much that's going on in the school. There's so much bullying. And there's so many kids killing themselves because of depression and stuff. But we don't want that fate to be for our children. We plead the blood of Jesus over our children, that God will keep them and that he will protect them and shield them and cover them as they, you know, bide under the shadow of the Almighty. Okay? So if you have prayer, you can come up after we've dismissed, and Pastor and those will pray with you, pray over you, whatever it is that you need. And if you haven't received him as your Lord and Savior, I invite you to come as well. If everyone would bow their heads. Heavenly Father, we come in the mighty name of Jesus. God, we just thank you for your goodness and your mercy. God, we thank you for your grace, for your grace is sufficient, oh God. Lord, we love you. We thank you. We thank you, God, for your presence here today. God, we thank you for every individual that ministered unto you, Lord. Father, your word says, suffer the little children to come unto me and forbid them not, for such is the kingdom of God. God, you wish that we all, even adults, will be as little children. They have that faith to trust you, to believe you, Lord God. Father, we thank you, Lord God, for ministering through the kids today, God. Bless them in a special way, Lord God. From this day forward, Lord God, let them draw closer to you, Lord God, as you speak to them, Lord, as you show them things, Lord. We play a hedge of protection around them this summer, oh God. So there's many mishaps that occur, but God, we plead the blood of Jesus over every child that's in this building today, Lord God. Cover them in your blood. Keep them, protect them, shield them from hurt, harm, and danger, Lord God. Cause them, oh God, to just to hear your voice, God, to spend time with you, Lord God. Even during that summer, as they have their summer reading, for those that are still in school, Lord, give them a word, oh God, that they will spend some time getting in reading their Bible, God, getting to know you, Lord. Father, bless them and keep them, Lord God. Put a fire in them, oh God, that they, you know, when it's time for the next fifth Sunday, God, that they will run to Sister Michelle, that they'll run to Sister D and say, I want to be, I want to do. Lord God, give them a heart and desire, oh God, to, Lord, to be used of you, Lord God. You use them to your glory, God. In the mighty name of Jesus, God, I thank you that you'll stir up the gift, oh God, that's within them, Lord God. Put a fire in them, oh God. God, that they would say, Lord, use me, God. Use me, Lord. Here am I, Lord. Use me. God, I thank you, Lord God, for blessing them, keeping them, oh God, and covering them in your blood, God. I thank you for a spirit of excitement, oh God, in the name of Jesus. And God, I thank you most of all for stirring up the Holy Ghost on the inside of them, oh God. Father, I thank you, Lord, that they will run and not be weary. They will fall
walk. And I thank God. Thank you, Lord God, that you will cause them, God, to mount up with wings as an eagle, oh God. Father, I thank you for doing a mighty good work in them. God, I thank you, Lord God, for you who have begun a good work is able to complete it. Complete the work in them, Lord God, in the mighty name of Jesus. God, we thank you. God, we praise you. Go with us, oh God. Keep us and cover us in your blood and bring us back at the appointed time. Father, we thank you and we praise you for these and all the many other blessings. In Jesus' name, amen.